You're next in line for the official Holiday World Podcast.
Welcome to Holiday World and Splash and Safari.
Dropping in from Santa Claus, Indiana.
Riders will experience swift acceleration, high-speed turns, and sudden stops.
With park president and CEO, Matt Eckert.
After that bacon soda, I'll try anything.
Fourth-generation owners, Lauren Crosby.
I came back. I'm here.
And director of communications, Leah Cook. They'll stow your loose articles. Buckle up.
And please keep your hands and legs inside the car at all times.
And we're back. Welcome back to season two of the official Holiday World podcast. This is season two, episode 16, the one where time flies when you're chasing fun. Today is, we recorded this on several days, but we expect to release this on July 12th. If you notice, no one has rudely interrupted me yet. That's because I'm flying solo for this episode because, frankly, our Ho-Wo-Po gang is pretty busy right now. We want to send a special shout out to Matt Eckert and the entire Eckert family. Matt had a recent loss in his family, so please keep them in your thoughts and prayers. In this episode, we're going to dive into Cheetah Chase, and we're going to let you hear from some of the personalities that got to ride. But I want to take a serious moment just to tell you to send some appreciation to someone who you know who works at a theme park or somewhere in the hospitality industry this year. I don't know about other parks, but I know that we went through a lot just to get our gates open this year, and we're going through a lot every day. We're a business that's frankly built for volume, and we're having to adjust every day and learn social distancing, and it's been hard for us, and we're going to get it wrong sometimes, but we're really grateful to everyone who has given us the benefit of the doubt. I don't think there's a single park this summer that's going to have the year that they thought they were going to have. I've watched a lot of parks get hit on social media, and I really just hope that all of you fans of the amusement park industry understand how hard we're working and how much we care. We're not thinking about this year, and we're not thinking about profits this year. We're just thinking about getting through to next year. So I hope you all understand, and I just really appreciate you guys giving me a minute to talk about this. You know, this year we're just thinking about our employees and trying to help them, trying to stay in business so that we can continue paying them so they can take home money for their families and continue to support their own families. I don't know what else to say other than it's been a difficult year, but our industry has been around for years and we're going to get through it. But if you know someone in the tourism or hospitality industry, please remember that we're all doing our best to survive and get through this year. Give them a virtual hug or send them a note. We all need it these days. And now it's time for some Ho-Wo-Po feedback. This isn't going to be your typical feedback episode, and it's not going to be the full feedback from the last couple months because we've missed on a lot and you guys have been active lately. So we're going to take a couple things from our frequent commenters and we'll be back with a full feedback episode soon enough. First, we heard from Raptor Girl May 6th. At Raptor Girl 94. Oh my word, homemade Ho-Wo surely made hashtag merry memories with my youngest son. We made the frozen hot chocolate from Holiday World and it is so good. Guys, we heard from Raptor Girl a couple times. Thank you so much for reaching out to us. If you haven't participated in our digital opening day or our digital fun town, that stuff still exists. We basically made a bunch of resources so you can bring a theme park home. So, you know, if you're immunocompromised and don't want to come to an amusement park this year, we totally get it. And we've come up with a lot of ways that you can keep an amusement park at home. You can make some of these treats, that frozen hot chocolate we heard a ton about. So I highly encourage you to check that out. Next, we heard from Bob Green at Bob05. We went for a 2.3 mile walk as conditioning for coaster season today. First of all, love that. As a reward for our walk, we took a virtual ride on the voyage from Holiday World while on the trail. We had a few funny looks. Bob, I would love to see a video of you on that walk, but I really love that you took a break and watched our virtual videos. Next, we heard from David Y at David Y. This is a promo I'd expect from Holiday World. This is actually a Denny's tweet that he retweeted, and it's a bacon face mask. So, guys, we didn't get to claim one, but we... we will consider that in the future if COVID-19 continues to demand face masks of us in the future. We will consider that one. We also heard from a couple people, no one in particular, but we've heard a lot of questions about Hollywood Nights. We have rescheduled that. I just want to call that out. We're still working out a lot of the details and kind of, you know, anytime we've tried to make plans more than a couple months in advance, it seems to really bite us. So we're going to wait to announce just exactly how we're going to do ERT. I know at Coaster Spotting, Alexander asked about how ERT will work. The short answer is we don't know yet because we're still figuring it out. And like I said, if we try to do anything more than a couple months out, we tend to find that we're completely wrong by that time. So we're just keeping our mouths shut now. But the event has been scheduled for August 28th and 29th, and it's going to overlap with Coasting for Kids. So such a great charity, and it's with Give Kids the World. So we're really excited to overlap those. And I also had another Bob Green tweet from @Bob05. Who else is season pass excited about the opening day of Holiday World tomorrow? This was back in June. We have a visit in the works for the future. I just want to take a moment to re-explain Season Pass Excited was from back in the day of Paula, where she accidentally, and mind you, typos from Paula were so rare that it was so delicious that she sent us something completely wrong. But she said, glad to see you're so excited, but she spelled so S-P and had her phone trained to correct SP to season pass. So she said, glad to see your season pass excited. And that's a thing that stuck. So I just thank you, Bob Green, for appreciating that reference and keeping it alive. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Next, we heard from Alex Chabokas. I will get it right one day. Dang it. I actually got to meet Alex. He came into the park on June 28th. He actually tweeted at us, at Alex Chabokas, ticket purchase for at Holiday World for June 28th. Hopefully some of the hashtag Ho'opo squad will be available for a picture. If you want to check it out, Alex and I did take a picture, masks on, slightly distanced. So we got to meet up and have a nice little conversation. I'm sure by now you've noticed that this isn't really our typical episode. We decided that we would have a little bit of fun and have some man on the street interviews. So rather than us sitting around a table telling you how fun Cheetah Chase is, we decided that we would have a couple of the personalities who checked out our media day tell you what it's like to ride Cheetah Chase. We were so excited. We happened to reach out to Marcus Leshock to see if he might possibly be available. If you don't know who Marcus Leshock is, he is a personality out of Chicago. He's on WGN. He is so good at what he does, but he describes roller coasters. He loves roller coasters. He describes roller coasters like no one I've ever seen before. He is so great. We happened to reach out and he happened to be on his way back from a preview day for Orion. And we got to catch up with him and hear his thoughts after he rode Cheetah Chase. This is Leah Cook. I'm here with the Ho'opo out on the streets today with Marcus Leshock. Marcus, thanks for joining us.
Hi, how are you?
I'm doing well. We're so excited to have you. Marcus, you have just ridden Cheetah Chase now. Tell us about it.
Well, first of all, I think it's really unfair that you guys have this ride and your other water rides that you have. Because once again, it's probably like one of the best water rides I've ever been on. And you have all of them in your one park.
Well, I'm honored. Right, thank you. We do brag about being the water coaster capital of the world now. So.
And it is seriously a ton of fun. It makes me want to come back when there's a bunch of people here and the boats are going at the same time on both sides to see that.
Do you want to race right now? I mean, we've got more people coming right now.
Yeah, maybe once they're done and they go do that, I will go again. Yeah. And what I love about it is it's fast, right? But it's re-rideable. Like, you could go on this over and over and over again and just have a ton of fun. I love how, because looking at the animation and everything that you guys posted, I wasn't really sure, like, where it was going to fit in the park and how it was going to fit. Like, this is a really creative use of space where you put it. And to be able to put this kind of attraction in this footprint is really impressive. Like, it's really impressive.
I wish I could say that I came up with that, but definitely the designers at ProSlide and some of our executives came up with that, and I wish I could say that was mine, but...
So, whose idea was it to have, like, the dual launching thing? Did they approach you with that? Did you guys come up with it?
So, I was actually away getting my MBA at the time when this kind of came into reality, so I don't know how exactly it came about, but I do know that Rick Hunter's been trying to come to us with the ProSlide, has been trying to come up to, with everything for us and just going, well, what about this? Would you build this? And so we came up with a bunch of different drafts, and
so
clearly I hope it paid off.
No, it totally did. And so you said like max speed of 30 feet per second. You get going on this. Like you really do get going. The launching up at the front of the slide is really fun. Like that's a really unique, really cool element. And then from there, it's just speed, and you get a little bit of airtime, a little bit here and there, but completely safe. You know, I didn't feel like it was out of control at all or anything like that. It's just a lot of fun, and especially when here, you guys gets hot here, right? And you get wet on this, like you get really, really wet. There's no way you're gonna come off like a little bit dry. I'm completely soaked. Like every inch of me is wet. It's crazy.
I was gonna say, I'm like, I've been debating on whether we should share about it or not. But do you want to explain what happens once you get to the top of each hill?
When you first go and you go up the hill, I'm like, oh, okay, like I'm getting sprayed a little bit. But once you get up to the top, it's like somebody ran up behind you with like a garbage truck full of water and just dumped it on top of your head and into your lap. Like,
there's so perfect.
I don't quite understand what is happening, but I think it's from all the spray coming up to push the boats up. I don't know, I'm not an engineer, but it was interesting.
Well, Marcus, also, you know, I'm doing everything in backwards order. Do you want to explain to people who you are? Because some of our podcast listeners may not know.
Sure. I work at WGN-TV in Chicago. I'm an anchor and reporter on the WGN Morning News, TV Morning News. And I have a segment called Coasting the Country where I travel all over the place and ride roller coasters, I visit theme parks, just talk about travel and things like that, and water parks too. And I've been to Holiday World in the past. You guys are awesome. Did a whole segment here when we were out here last time. And, you know, it's enough of a drive from Chicago. It's not too far. It's like 5 or 6 hours to get here. And so just coming down to check this out.
Marcus is like the coaster expert now. If you want some news official who really knows their coasters, Marcus is the guy for you.
Yeah, I think there's other people that are like have definitely been on more coasters than me, but I know a lot because I'm the nerd that looks everything up and my mission to ride as many things as I can and visit as many places as I can.
I just love the way you describe coasters. You're a pro at it now. You're really skilled at it, unlike me talking right now. I'm like losing my words now.
Yeah,
I'm so used to being interviewed today that I'm not
good. Right. See, I like to ask the questions. I don't like to answer the questions, right? So I like to be the one asking. So it's kind of weird, but...
Well, thanks so much for joining us. Do you want to explain your shirt, too, for our podcast listeners?
Yeah, sure. So my shirt right now says Sylvie Strong on us. If you see the video of me on the ride, that's what that says. Mark Silverman is a radio host on ESPN 1000 in Chicago, and he announced somewhat recently that he has lymphoma and he's battling lymphoma. So a bunch of us bought these shirts, and they're all going to a foundation that's raising money for a cure. And he's a great guy. He's also a huge theme park fan. Like, he loves going to theme parks, riding roller coasters, always asking me. So I figured I was coming here today. I'm going to wear the shirt. Everyone's wearing the shirt in unique places. So my first ride on this is the first of its kind water coaster, right? Yeah. So, you know, that's a great way to debut the shirt that I'm wearing it. So that's why I'm wearing it today.
I love that. Guys, check that out. Well, Marcus, I don't want to take up too much of your time because we want to let you get back to riding. So thanks so much for joining us today.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
I will forever be proud that Marcus LeShock called it unfair that we have this trio of water coasters. So thanks so much for stopping by. Next, we caught up with a friend of the pod squad, Chad Benefield. He's been a part of like the last couple episodes. Honestly, at this point, he's been a part of most of season two. So, hey, thanks so much, Chad, for always joining us. But we also heard from one of his friends at his country music station, WBKR in Owensboro, Barb. So they got together and told us what they were expecting out of their first ride on Cheetah Chase.
Welcome, Howell Poe fans. We've got a friend of the podcast. Chad, I feel like you're on every episode now. We just like have slowly like adopted you into the podcast.
But you know what? I love being on, and I'm so excited about being on today to talk about Cheetah Chase.
And we've got Barb as well.
Welcome. I'm so excited.
Can I just tell you that Barb went to change, and I'm pretty sure it took her 20 minutes to change into official Cheetah Chase attire. She is ready.
Ready.
I love it.
Ready to chase.
Also, I've been in that bathroom today. I'm going to say, it's hot and it is not easy to change into a swimsuit in that bathroom.
That's why it took a little longer, Chad.
So I was here a couple of weeks ago to get a behind-the-scenes tour for the first media day for the dry park, but I got to sneak back here. This ride looks so much different with water blasting through it, especially at the top of the first launch hill. That looks crazy.
So, what do you think of this?
Well, for me, Chad talks me into a lot of things that, like, normally are out of my comfort zone. And this would be a little out of my comfort zone, but I am psyched. I'm so ready to go. I mean, it's going to be just amazing.
We might need before and after pictures of you guys, because I don't know if anyone's warned you, but you're going to get soaked.
That's what I heard. I heard we're going to get soaked, and I might be screaming a little bit, too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Eric and Josh Moore told me when they rode for the test rides, they said something that you don't expect, but when you go up the first hill, all the water that was used to propel the boat up the hill comes rushing up over the back side of you and drenches you. I'm here for it.
Well, I'm here for it, and I'm glad I used the restroom because it is. I heard the water is very cold.
Very cold. It is at that. It is at that.
Hey, it's a 90-degree day. Bring it on.
Bring it on.
So what are you expecting out of this? What do you think? Are you guys going to race together? Are you going to go against each other?
We're going to go together at least the first time.
Yeah. Okay. For sure. And I'm really curious to see, you know, like how, if we do race against somebody, like how that works out. I'm really curious to like get behind the science of this. I know it's going to be fun, but I'm really curious to see like how fast our boat goes, if we smoke the other people, if we lose.
Well, and I'm wondering too about weight. Like, does it make a difference the size of the people in the boat, or does that matter? So if you're really small, you're going to just be flying. And if you're not as small, you might be just a little slower.
I think I've heard that there's kind of like a sweet spot in the weight range that like, or like weight distribution that like the heavier boats tend to go a little better, but there's a point of diminishing returns.
Okay. So I feel like I'm in high school wrestling now. Like we're going to make a weight class and we'll see if we're successful in that weight class. If not, we'll drop down or move up.
And me and Chad are both competitive. So now I'm second guessing going the first time by ourselves.
I think you guys should each pick a team member from the rest of your sister stations and go against each other so we can tell them who wins.
I like your style, and we're going to win.
I do too. I just want to say we should adopt Leah on Team Chad and Barb.
I will gladly join. All right. Well, we'll check back in with you guys in a little bit.
Hey, we're going to ride.
So there's what they were expecting. There's their anticipation. I love it. But, you know, now let's check in and see what they thought. I just want to preface this and say that I figured I would check in after their first ride. But, you know, it was a media event, so I got pulled away in a few different directions. And I think it felt like about an hour later, I finally caught up with them and was able to get their thoughts on all of the rides that they took. So have a listen.
So it was pretty average, right?
Not even close to being average. That is a blast, and I don't want to stop riding.
I don't want to stop either, but I have to go to work. But it was so fun. I mean, how many times did we ride?
Oh, my gosh. Probably 20 at least.
I would guess at least. But it was fun chasing each other. That's when it really, really was pretty cool, is when we decided to, you know, just go on it and chase each other, see how fast we could go and who's going to win.
Who won most?
Honestly, I think it probably averaged out, and I think that's what's going to be really cool about it for families, because there is, like, this sense of competition that builds immediately when you get in. You're like, okay, Cheetah Chase, it's on.
Yeah, and it was on. I mean, what a ride. So much fun. I mean, you're going to get wet a lot, but that's okay. It makes it more fun.
And so we kept running variables. Like, we would alternate who was sitting in the front, in the middle, in the back. We would try to synchronize our leaning around the corners to, like, be more aerodynamic. It was hilarious.
Water dynamic?
Yeah, water dynamic,
I was going to say, all of a sudden, we're on the bobsled team.
Exactly.
I love it.
But it's so much fun. Oh. And what's really cool, too, is there are places, like, design in the track where you can see how you're doing against the other team. Mm-hmm. It's really fun.
Yeah, it's so fun.
I love that. Yeah, I love that. I feel like I went missing for, like, half an hour and came back to you guys soaking wet. So.
Yeah, we're still, well, and that's a really cool thing. You know, we heard the rumors that at the top of the first hill, the water just comes gushing over you. That doesn't just happen at the top of the first hill. That's every hill.
Oh, every hill. I mean, you barely get the water out of your eyes. But what's nice is, like he said, though, you could get the water out just enough to look over and see your competitor, which was so fun.
And when you can't see them along the course, you can hear them.
Oh, yeah.
And so you can actually kind of gauge where you are in relation to them by where their voices are. It's so fun.
Oh, my gosh. It's so fun.
Any advice to future riders?
Ooh. Okay. So we probably learned some tricks of the trade along the way, don't you think?
I was thinking women don't wear any makeup and don't do your hair.
it's like an instant, like, backwards blowout. Yes.
I love that you're thinking cosmetic and I'm thinking competitive.
Yes.
So, yeah, I mean, honestly, like, I feel like if you lean into the hills, it gives you a little bit of speed going down them. But let me tell you, if you fall behind, you can actually make up some ground going up the last hill and then coming down the last hill. A couple of different times, we passed each other on the last hill going down.
Exactly, and it was interesting.
If you have somebody in your party, not naming names, Barb, who questions your judgment on the photo finishes, just know that if you think you won, you're right.
Oh, whatever.
Now, we've had people advised to wear goggles. Would you support that advice?
No. No, go for it. All natural.
Yeah. Now, were you guys like open your eyes underwater type of kids?
Oh, absolutely. Oh, yeah.
See, that was never me. So I would advise goggles, but I'll trust you guys.
I think the only time I closed my eyes was when they took the first ride because I didn't know what to expect.
And I will say our buddy Ryan did note that at the top of the first hill going down, he did get like water up the nose. It has like a little neti pot action going on. So you may want to hold your breath at the top of the hill, but it's a blast.
That.
Nice.
Yeah.
Recommended.
Awesome.
So much fun. Five
Right. Well, thanks so much for joining us, guys. We appreciate it.
Cheetah Chase, huge addition to the park. Love it.
I don't want to speak too soon, but I think we have a hit on our hands. Thanks so much, Chad and Barb. It's so fun listening to them again. I just want to add my own thoughts that, you know, I actually haven't gotten to ride. We changed boats in the middle of the testing process, so I haven't actually gotten to ride yet on the new boats, but I hear they're much faster and even more fun, which I can't even imagine right now. But, you know, I promise podcast listeners, I will get out there soon and I will be riding and I will report back to you with the new boats. But I'm just so proud of the whole team that pulled this whole attraction together in the middle of a pandemic. What rock stars we have on our team. And just, it's been so amazing to work with ProSlide, and I could gush for hours and hours, and Lauren and Matt aren't here to stop me from doing it. So it's a real problem right now, but I just want to make sure everyone who worked on this, on our team gets all the kudos they deserve, because they did such an amazing job. With that being said, congratulations. You've chased your way to the end of another episode. Please join us in some number of weeks. Who knows when, because some of you may have noticed that we skipped a week already. But, you know, we're trying to stay with it and trying to stay up for you. But anyway, please join us in some number of weeks for during your next commute, cleaning session, etc. for our next episode, season 2, episode 17. Honestly, topic to be determined, you know. It's COVID-19. We're just doing the best we can. Anyway, thank you to all our behind-the-scenes pod squad, Steven, Josh, and Sabrina. Thanks for not letting the podcast become an afterthought. Listeners, if you don't know the names of Steven, Josh, and Sabrina, just know they're the ones putting in the hard work day in, day out to make the podcast continue existing. They're rock stars. And thanks to all of you for listening and for being patient with us while we miss a week and work everything out. Please subscribe and leave a review on iTunes, Spotify, Google Podcasts, YouTube, Facebook, etc., and tell all your friends. On behalf of today's Pod Squad, myself, but also Absent Matt and Mama Lauren, thank you. Please be sure to share your feedback and questions with us by calling us at 812-937-4401 and dial 8081, by emailing us at podcast@holidayworld.com, or by reaching out to us on social media using the hashtag HoWoPo.
You've been listening to the official Holiday World Podcast.
Welcome back. Did you enjoy your flight?
A production of Holiday World and Splash and Safari in Santa Claus, Indiana. Check out the latest episodes at holidayworld.com/podcast. Thanks for taking a ride with us.
And please come back to see us again soon.
Are you looking for a fun summer job with flexible schedules? We're hiring now at holidayworldjobs.com.